Good morning, dear students. Today we will learn the questions from the exercise 8C. Some of the questions we have done in the previous session. From this session, we will learn from question number 8. So basically, these questions are a little bit different type of questions. Here we have to use our logic, whatever the logic we have learned in the previous two exercises. And this C exercise, that logic we are going to use in this exercise, it is a little bit different type of questions. But we can say that these questions are important as well, because this type of questions can be asked in your competitive exams in the future if you are going to attend MPSC exams, UPSC exams, SSC exams, NDA exams. In that, all type of the competitive exams, this topic plays an important role. Okay, so let us see the question number 8. Four men or 6 women earn rupees 360 in one day. See what that given is information. Four men or 6 women earn rupees 360 in one day. Okay, this is the given thing. Now, the first part of the question. See, what is the first part of the question? Find how much will a man earn in one day. One day will be equals to. See, what is the word that you used here? 4 men or 6 women. That means for the 4 men, 360 rupees in one day. And also, separately we can say that 6 women will earn 360 rupees in one day. Okay, means both of these two things contain the same amount, 360 rupees. So man earn in the one day will be what? 360 upon 4 men, so divided by 4. So how much it is? 90 rupees. 4 is the 4, 4 is the 36 and 0. So 90 rupees is the income of the one day. Second part, the same, second part. What is the second part? A woman earning one day equals to. Now see what they are saying. 6 women can earn 360 rupees in one day. So 1 woman can earn 360 divided by 6, that is 360 in one day. Is that clear? Similarly, there is a third part as well. What is the third part? 6 men and 4 women earn in one day. 6 men and 4 women earn in one day. It will be like this. Now, for the 1 man, earning of one day is 90 rupees. So, for the 6 men, what will be the earning of one day? 6 into 9. Correct? 4 women earn in the one day. As we know, 1 woman earning of the one day is rupees 60. And we want to calculate for 4 women. So multiply it by 4. We want to calculate the earning of 6 men and means what? Addition. Means Combinedly, we want to find out the earning of 6 men and 4 women. Therefore, we have used here addition sign. Now, according to the bond mass, first we will multiply and then add. So, multiplication 9, 6 are 540. 6, 4 are 240. So, the final answer will be what? 0, 4 plus 4, 8, 5 plus 2 is 7. Rupees 780 is the earning of 6 men and 4 men in 1 day. Okay. Now, we are solving the question number 9. Question number 9. We are solving now. Please note it down in your notebooks. Pause the video and write the things in your notebook. Writing is very important in mathematics. Next, question number 9. Question number 9 we are solving. See, what is the question number 9? 16 boys went to a canteen to have tea and snacks together. The bill amounted to rupees 414.40. What will be the contribution of a boy who pays for himself and 5 others? 16 boys went to a canteen, have a tea and snacks together. The bill amounted. Bill amounted is rupees 114.40. Okay. So from this information, we can calculate the bill amount of one boy. Okay. Therefore, one boy bill amount A equals to P's. Or instead of this, you can just write 1.40 divided by 16. It will give us rupees 7.15. Let's put it here. So once we calculate this amount, now our question is what? The question is, what will be the contribution of a boy who pays for himself and 5 others? So contribution of boy contribution on by who pays himself and 5 others will be equals to what? For the one person or one boy, 7.50. He is paying for 5 others and himself, means total it is 6 people or 6 boys. Got it? Khud ka to bhar rahi hai wo, plus 5 other log ka bhar. So 1 plus 5 makes 6. So the final answer will be 42.90. This will be the final answer. Okay. So please write it down here. Next, we are solving with the question number 10. Question number 10 we are solving here. The question is, 50 laborers can dig a pond in 16 days. How many laborers will be required to dig another pond doubled in size in 20 days? Okay. So, first statement of the question is, 50 laborers can dig a pond in 60 days. 50 laborers can dig a pond in how many days? 16 days. This is the first statement of the question. Therefore, work done by 50 workers, therefore, work done by 50 workers is equals to 50 multiplied by 60. This is the work done by the workers to build that pond, okay, or to dig that pond. Is that clear? Now, our question is what? If we want to build a pond of double size, means the work will also get doubled, correct? And also there is some limit given to us. What they are saying? To build the double size pond in 20 days. Okay? So let us find out the double work done. Therefore, work done to dig the pond of double size equals to 50 to 60. Okay. This much of the work that should be required to dig the double size of it is a single size pond. Work done is 50 into 16, and if the same size get doubled, so we should multiply it by 2, correct? So therefore, now we want to find out, what we need to find out? How many laborers will be required to dig another pond double in the size in 20 days? We want to find out the number of laborers dig the pond in 20 days. So, for that, what we need to do here? Whatever the work done is here, divided by number of days, 50 multiplied by 16 multiplied by 2 divided by 20. 0, 0 get cancelled, 130 get cancelled, 16 5s are 18 laborers. So that means we can say that dig the pond of double size, to dig the pond of double size, we need 80 laborers for 20 days. Is that clear? I hope all of you understood this. If you have any doubt, you can help. Then, question number 11 we are solving. Question number 11. In this question number 11, question is, if 12 men or 18 women can complete a piece of work in 7 days, in how many days can 4 men and 8 women complete the same work? So, in this question, what they are saying? 12 men or 18 women? 12 men or 18 women can complete a piece of work in 7 days. Can complete the piece of work in 7 days. That means, what we can say here from this statement, if we use 12 men to complete the work, they can complete it in the 7 days. Or second option is there, if we use 18 women to complete the same work, they can complete the work in 7 days. That is the meaning of statement. So it means, it is very clear that work of 12 men equals to the work of 18 women. Is that clear? Work of 12 men equals to the work of 18 women. If we want to find out the work of 1 man, therefore work of 1 man equals to 18 upon 12. Understood? 18 upon 12, work of 10. Now, the next part of our question is what? If, what they are saying? If 4 men and 8 women complete the same work. 4 men and 8 women. So, if one man is there, its work done will be 18 upon 12 of the work of men. And suppose, work of 4 men. So, we should multiply it by 4. 18 upon 12 into 4. Work of, okay. 4 ones are 4, 4 is a 2, 3 ones are 3, 6 are 18. That means, work of 4 men will be equals to 6. Work of 6 women. Is that clear to everyone? Work of 4 men equals to the work of 6 women. Okay. So please note it down because I want to rub this upper 3 lines. Now, what is our main question here? We want to find out the work done by 4 men and 8 women. 4 men and 8 women. 4 men and 8 women. So here, 4 men and 8 women. So what we can say? 4 men and 8 women. Let us convert everything into the women. Means work done by the women. As we know, 4 men can do the piece of work of 6 women. So 6 plus this 8, we will convert the work done by this man and woman to 2. So 6 plus 8 will become 14. So it means work done by 4 men, work done by 8 women will be equals to the work done of 14 men. Okay? This thing is given in the question. We want to find out the work done by the 4 men, 8 women. And here is the relation of the 4 women. 4 men can do the piece of work of 6 women. Okay? So instead of the 4 men, we put up 6 plus 8. 6 women plus 8 women. Or just to make it easy, we can also write it in this way. 4 men stands for 6 to 1 plus 8 to 1. So that means total there are the 14. Now our question is, 14 women can do the work in how many days? So as we have the relation here, 14 men can do the work in x days. 14 women can do the work in x days. Now again move to the first statement of our question. What was the first statement of the question? 12 men or 18 women can do the piece of work in 7 days. So we can say that 18 women can do the work. 18 women can do the work in 7 days. As work done and timing is there, so between work and time, which type of proportion is there? Number of women and time. There is an inverse proportion, and since there is the inverse proportion, we will make a multiplication of 14 into x and 18 into 7. So 14 is in the multiply, 15 side goes for division, correct? 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 9. So value of the x will be 9. So what we can say? 4 men and 8 women can do the piece of work in how many days? 9 days. So it will take 9. Okay. After this question, we are going to solve the question number 13. Question number 13 we are going to solve. Question number 13 is here. The question is, a particular work can be completed by 6 men and 6 women in 24 days, whereas the same work can be completed by 8 men and 12 women in 50 days. Find first, according to the amount of the work done, one man is equivalent to how many women? And the second, the time taken by 4 men and 6 women to complete the same work. Okay. So here we want to find out that instead of the men and women, if only men can do the piece of work, that how many times they are greater or how many times they are in the work proportional to each other. So what is the first statement of the question? 6 men and 6 women. 6 men, 6 women can complete the work in how many days? 24 days. So if we multiply, or this work done of the one day will be got 1 upon 24. And if we multiply this 6 by 24, it will become work of the one day. If we want to convert it into work of the one day, then 24 into 6 is 144 men. It will be 144 women. And this is the one day. Let it be the equation number 1. Understood what we have done? We have converted into the work done in one day. Here it was 24 days. Suppose we want to convert, or we want to find out the work done in the one day. So we multiply it by 24, and also we multiply it by 24. So this much of men and women is required to do the work in one day. Is that clear? Another condition is there. 8 men and 12 women. 8 men and 12 women can do the piece of work in the 15 days. Okay. So once again, if we want to convert it into 1 day, we want to find out the work done in the 1 day. So again, 15 is here, so multiply 8 into 15. 15 is how much? It will be 120 man plus 12 into 15 is how much? 180 women can do the piece of work in the 1 day. This is our equation number 2. Okay. Now, in both of the cases, in the first and in the second, in both of the cases, the same work is done. Means, ek hi kaam karne wale ho. So, therefore, the first and the second statement are equal because both of the value is 1 and this is also 1. Their RHS are equal, then their LHS are also equal. Okay. So, let us equate these two things. Equating 1 and 2. So it is 144 men plus 144 men equals to 120 men, 180 women. 120 men plus 180. Understood what we have done? We just equated the first and the second equal with each other. Now let us shift number of men in one side, number of women in other side. So it will be like this: 144 men minus, this is plus, if same minus 120 men. And similarly, 144 women is plus, going that side with the minus 182 minus 144. Okay. So difference of these two, 144 minus 120, how much is that? It will be 24 men equals to subtraction of last two. Will gives us 36 women. The first part of our question is to find out work done by the one man equals to how much work done by the one woman. That we need to calculate. So here 24 is in the multiplier, on that side goes for division. So here we can say that one man equals to 36 upon is 36 upon 24. Number of. So 12 twos are 12 threes are. So here we can say that one man stands for 3 upon 2 times of work done of men. This is the relation between the work done by men and women. Okay. So once we get this relation, then the second part of our question. See, what is the second part of our question here? The time taken by 4 men and 6 women to complete the same work. Time taken by 4 men and 6 women. Time taken by 6 men and 4 women. Men and 6 women. This we need to find out. Time taken. The same amount of. Okay. So for that, what we need to do once again? As we know that 4 men. 4 men means this is 1 man, we have 4 men, stands for 3 by 2 times of and means plus sign. Ones are 2, these are 4, so it becomes, these are 6 women plus 6 women. So that means 12 women. You want to find out the volume for the 12 women. Okay. So we have converted the condition of man and woman directly in the women, 12 women. Now see students, 12 women can do the work in 15 women can do the work in 24 days. As in the first question, 6 men and 6 women can do the piece of work in 24 days. So for 12 women, 12 women can do the work in X days. Correct? Now the first statement of the question is what? 6 women and 6 men and 6 women can do the work in 24 days. 6 men and 6 women can do the work in 24 days. It is given question. So 6 men, 1 man stands for how much? 3 by 2 women. So here we can say 3 upon 2 times of woman plus 6 women. 24 days. 1s are 2, 3s are 3. 3s are 6. 3, 3s are 9 women plus 6. 9 plus 6 women will be 24 days. So 9 plus 6 means what? 15 women for 24 days. So from this statement what we understand, 15 women can do the piece of work in 24 days and our question is to find out 12 women can do the piece of work in X days. So since the work and number of women are there, that is between them there is a inverse variation. So let us solve this inverse variation question. See, for 12 women X days. So here we can write 12 multiplied by x equals to 15 women can do the work in 24 days. So it will be 15 24. Correct? 12 is in the multiplication, 2 in that side goes for division. Hence the value of x 15 multiplied by 24 equals 12. 12 is 12, 12 15 is 30. It means it will take 30 days to complete the work. Okay. Got it? This will be the final answer. So for today we will stop here. Thank you everyone.